In this video, we're going to walk very quickly through the creation, simulation, and deployment of a simple project so you can get a feel for the whole project flow from beginning to end. Here's the end result, a three-screen project with a title screen, a utility control screen, and an oven temperature monitoring screen with alarms. Nothing fancy, just the basics. Let's see how we got there. Step 1. Create a new project. File, Start Project, Make New Project. Select the folder you want to put the project in. Give the project a name. Select the panel type. We'll use the 3-inch touchscreen for this example. And select the PLC that you're connecting to. We're using an Automation Direct Click PLC, so we'll choose that one. Step 2, create the screens. We already have our first screen, we just need to rename it. I'm going to right-click, click on Rename, and change that to our home screen. Add a new screen. This is screen 2. That'll be our utility screen. And we'll make him yellow. Screen 3 is our oven temperature screen. And we'll make him red. Step 3, fill in the screens. Our title screen is easy. We just add static text by dragging the static text object onto the screen. Fill in the text we want. Say OK. Resize to fit. And we're ready for screen 2. Screen 2 is our utility control screen. We'll add a bar switch right here to control the fan tag. We haven't created any tags yet, so we click on this button, add a tag, call it the fans tag. This will be a discrete tag located at memory address C100 on the click PLC. While we're at it, we know we also need a lights tag, so let's go ahead and add him in. He'll also be a discrete at address C101 on the click PLC. So we want this switch to control the fans tag. We've chosen the rocker switch out of the library. Make him a little bit smaller. Now I'm going to simply copy this by saying control C, then pasting with control V. Put that on the screen, double click on it, and let's switch him to a horizontal rocker switch. And that'll be our light switch. We need for him to control the lights tag, so we simply switch it there. Go back down to our static text. This is our fans. I don't really want a border around that. Now I'm going to hold down the control key and drag a copy over here and change that to lights. I'm moving these up to make room for a menu later. Screen 3 is our oven temperature monitoring screen. We just drop an analog meter onto the screen. We need for it to monitor the oven temperature tag, which doesn't exist yet, so we go create one. Let's call this oven temp. This one will be an unsigned integer located at address DS200 on the click PLC. So this analog meter is going to monitor that oven temperature tag. And we'll also add some static text to label this guy. Now we could have used the text label that came with that dialog, but it's not very flexible. I like using the static text because I can resize it and move it wherever I want. I really don't like those borders though, so let's get rid of them. and now I have control over that text. I'm not relying on the dialog to generate it for me. I do need to leave room down here, though, for menu keys later, so we'll shrink that. Okay, that was step three, fill in the screens. Step four, we need to create an alarm when the temperature gets over 80 degrees. To do that, we go to Setup, Alarm Control Setup. We choose our oven temperature tag. When the oven temperature tag is greater than 80, we want to have beeps sound and have the backlight toggle between yellow and amber. So there's our oven temperature tag alarm. Step five, create a background menu screen. We're going to need a new screen for that. So we click on our new screen button. And let's go ahead and make that screen 100, just to show they don't have to be in any order. We'll call this our menu screen. And green is fine. To create the menu, we use this function object and simply assign the function keys to give us screen changes. So we'll have F1 be a screen change that'll take us to the home screen. F3 will be a screen change that takes us to the utility screen. And F5 will be a screen change that takes us to the oven temperature screen. We'll give them all proper labels here. There's our home screen. You can see those appear on the screen as we go. We're not using this guy. We're not using that guy. This is our utility screen. And this is our temperature screen. Now we have our menu. All we have to do now is apply this menu to all of the other screens. The way we do that is we notice this is screen 100. So when I go down to screen 3, I say I would like to use a background screen, the menu screen, and enable that. And those buttons now appear on this screen. We'll do the same thing for this screen. Add the menu screen, enable it, and our title screen. Add the menu screen and enable it. The temptation is to copy those buttons to all of the screens. But that's cumbersome and hard to maintain and manage. It's much easier to do it this way. So now whenever we need to make changes to our menu screen, we only have to modify this one screen. Step 6, simulate it. Hit the simulate button, and up pops our simulator with our new project. So F1 takes us home. F3 should take us to the utility screen where we can turn the fans on and off. And I'm watching this fan tag down here. This control window tells me what the tags on the PLC will be doing in the real project. So when I flip this switch, sure enough, I see that tag change. When I flip this switch, I see the lights tag change. Finally, the temperature screen. This analog meter is monitoring this oven temperature tag down on the PLC. I'll pretend I'm the PLC and go to temperature 34. And sure enough, my analog meter shows me that. Remember, if this temperature goes over 80 degrees, we should get alarms. So let's set our temperature at 81. And sure enough, we get the beeps and the blinking background screen. Once you're happy with the way your project's working, step 7 is send it on to the PLC. Click the send button. Do you want to save the changes? Sure. Check your COM port. Now, I don't remember which COM port my cable's plugged into, so I hit this little detail button. And I'm using this prolific cable here, so that's COM 4. Double click on that, it fills in COM 4 for me. When I'm ready, I have to reach over, hold down function keys F1 and F5 for a couple seconds, and that puts the panel into setup mode. When it's in that mode, I can hit transfer, and the software will send the project down to the panel. You can see it's transferring the runtime file, then it's transferring the project files, so I can retrieve those later, edit them, put them back on the panel. So I always have a handy copy of this project. The project's now on the panel, ready to go. For more detailed ideas and examples, check out the other videos in this series, especially the ones with the word demo or debug in them. They have lots of great ideas, tips, and tricks you can use in your own projects. There are some tutorial projects included with the software in the projects folder under the Seymour Micro install. For information on a specific topic like alarms, passwords, setting up your COM ports, etc., be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.